This pitcher.
It's catching.
Yeah.
Pitches. Swung makes me feel like a total badass. All day, every day. Like Seth Rogen. I think stupid and right dumb. Spit foolish and wise up. Getting more dead presidents on my bucks. Live life plush like I want. Basic king. I'm thinking of like King Joffy Joe. Got that, bro? Got that. How sick? Taj Mahal ill. Thoroughbred cars got whipped appeal. Front yard prospect. Back Central Park with wolves and a prowl and 1,000 guards. Money long like the Empire State or the Eiffel Tower. I like that pick. Plus, my women are goddesses. Venus statues so erotic. Pull them in with slang melodic. You scared over there? Okay, I got this. What you want, son? This is my game. This is my lane. Get out of the way. What you want, hun? This ain't my babe. This is my cake. Get out of my face. What you want, huh? This is my space. This is my page. Get out of my ape. What you want, huh? This is my stage. This is gonna sting. Coming at you on demand and live.
Yeah, boy.
That's right. This is the most badass hockey podcast in all the known land. I forgot from the heart of Europe, didn't I there?
That's right.
But no, from the dirtiest of dirty, New Jersey.
That's right. Yep. This is the hip-hop version of Shop of the Play. With Tommy C, I'm Missing Link. That's my hip-hop name.
Yo, yo. What's up? Yo, we're going to be talking about Kovalchuk, you know, like dipping out, going to Russia with his bitch ass, and, you know, a bunch of other shit.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? It's funny, I never know what the fuck those rap guys are saying.
Ever. I listened to a, on Shady XM, Eminem's radio station. They have probably one of the funniest shows that comes on Saturday. I don't even know if they're trying to be funny.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know what I just did? I spilled.
They had a promo called Sell Your... the weekend. It was Sell Your Pussy Weekend. If you're a hooker, escort, stripper, we want to know how you sell your pussy.
Wait, is this a podcast?
No, this is on XM.
Oh, God. That's right. You can talk like that on XM, right?
Yeah, it was like... We were just... Tracy and I were just listening to it. They had these girls calling up, and they're giving, like, their Instagram names. I'm like, Tracy, look her up. Look her up.
See, we know her.
Yeah.
Oh, I know that girl. She works in the Carol down the hall. What was the advice they gave?
They just wanted girls to call up and, you know, it's their escorts, webcam girls, and stuff like that. And they just... They just wanted to know, you know.
I got some advice for him. Move to Europe. It's legal.
Yeah.
Huh? No point in doing time for that. Getting some mob pimp slapping.
It's Sell Your Pussy Tuesday on Shop on the Point.
Yeah. How are you? How are you doing this summer, by the way?
I'm doing good. Just, you know, just the busyness is about to end.
Yeah, that's.
And we're about to, you know.
Make that move.
Make the move, and the wedding's almost here.
Yeah, how's that? How's that going over there in Pee Wee Land?
Oh, it's. I got a funny story about him.
Can we talk about it in the air? Don't. You better. You better walk. Tread carefully.
I don't think he listens. So.
Yeah, but it's on the air for good, and it's live now.
It's not. It's nothing. He got really drunk and threw up all over a 4-star restaurant.
Really?
Yeah, we went to this casino in like the Poconos, and he was drinking cheap beer. Him and Pete were just, you know, drinking this cheap beer and gambling and stuff. And,
oh man!
And we went to this is George's bachelor party.
Wait, you down in AC?
No, we were in Poconos.
You can gamble in the Poconos?
Yeah, they have a casino in Mount Airy.
Oh, yeah, that's all the Italian guys that suddenly figured out that they're Indians, and they open a casino, right?
Probably.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Hey, yo, I'm Chief Runs with Spaghetti. Hey. So we go to this nice, like, everything's like $40 a plate. Oh. And Steve's already drunk, but he's funny. He's being silly, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
He's making us laugh. So somebody gets the idea. It's like, let's buy Steve a shot. It's like, all right. So we all throw a dollar to go get him a shot. I forget what they get him, but shortly after taking the shot,
yeah,
his head's down sleeping.
Oh, really?
And by the end, he has like a $30.
What
plate
did you get him? What kind of shot did you get?
I can't even remember. But he was drinking like all day, like the cheap casino beer.
Oh, that'll put you over.
And then he's sitting there with his head down, $30 plate of chicken parm in front of him.
Oh.
And
was his parents there?
His dad.
Was everybody pissed off at him and yelled at him?
No, no one really was.
No one was there angry?
Not really. Not like at the current time. Like, not like the group, you know, because it was a bunch of guys. It's not like there was like a woman.
Waiter was pissed.
He didn't say like, you guys get out, because it is a casino, and I'm sure they've seen worse.
Yeah.
So like all of a sudden he gets up, and I notice my father-in-law walking with him. And he's like puking. Like, we're in like a private room where it's just our table. We're like separated from everyone. And they move the door, and he just starts puking, like, in his hand. There's like a couple under, I guess, like on a date, is sitting to the left of him as he's trying to get to the bathroom. Oh, God.
I know he doesn't listen, by the way.
I know he doesn't. He's probably going to listen. It's like, hey, let's check this out.
Yeah, the one time.
Yeah,
that we are live. And speaking of all you shots of the pointers, let me give you an update what we're doing right now. This is not an official episode. We are doing tests with the new Google Hangouts to possibly take callers next year. And what I found out since is, you know, Google has this other thing called live events. And what happens is you record live and it goes immediately to your YouTube channel, like on the Shot for the Point YouTube channel. And I want this live events. The closest thing I can do now is this Google Hangouts, this public Google Hangouts. But that kind of sucks because you can't stream at a real high quality. It's really only good for two or three people talking. And if you get the live events on YouTube, then you have absolutely no problems whatsoever. You can stream at a higher rate. You can do all, you know, you set times and dates, and it's something I really want. And I was told they're going to be passing it out slowly to each account. Right now it's grayed out in my account. And then I find out the big news today, the big sad news. You have to have 1,000 subscribers to get this thing. So I'm stuck with Google Hangouts until, A, they give it to me, which doesn't look like it's going to happen, or somehow I get 1,000 subscribers.
So folks, September. Start making your fake profiles and start liking a shot from the point. That's right.
Well, you know, you people that do listen during the season, I would really appreciate it if you shared it with your other hockey friends. And if you're on my Facebook page, and I know a lot of you liked it for a mercy like, which is fine with me because by mercy liking it, it gave me a bunch of options and crap of that nature. But, you know, if you know somebody likes hockey, I think it might be a nice move.
I post this into the Devils, fans of New Jersey Devils page, and I get a lot of likes on it.
Well, I imagine we would be a good East Coast hockey podcast.
That's right.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, I think. But
well, no one cares about hockey in L.A.
No. No, they cared for in 2012 of June. That's about it.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Like, holy crap, we have a hockey team. Huh?
Yeah, right.
What's going on at the Staples Center? The Lakers aren't playing.
They stole Staples at the Staples Center. Jeez. I don't know. California seems like a really bad sports town to me and what have you. So if you are listening to this on either on YouTube, what you can do is you head over to A Shot from the Point and Other Crap on Facebook. Like the bitch if you see it there. And you also click on the link and jump in, and you're more than likely feel free to call.
Yeah.
Call right in. And here's the
best thing. You can tell us we suck. I don't care.
Here's the best thing about this Google Hangout is it's not really perfect. Like, I can't mute your microphone as you log in, even though I have the setting on to do that, where I can like kind of unmute you and mute you. So it sounds like a normal radio show. Well, there's like a bug in it. So if you really want to destroy it or troll us, now would be the time to do it until I figure out a way around it. Or YouTube gives me the live event option where we get 1,000 subscribers.
That's right. This is the year we do it.
Yeah. Yeah, yep. I was so dejected when I saw that. So dejected. We did break the 60 spot over the summer.
I saw that.
Yeah, we're like 63. Yeah, I'm very happy about that.
Yeah, I know. That's. I mean, we're not even doing a live show. We got 3 new subscribers.
Sure.
We were doing live shows for we were stuck at 59.
Yeah. Well, we did our first live show was the final show.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, no, I'm talking about like up to current shows.
Yeah, up to current show. Yeah. What have you? I have an announcement to make. This is very, I don't know, this is kind of sad, so gather close to your speakers, folks. I have some really sad news. It has been brought to my attention that Ryan Lambert of Puck Daddy has blocked me from all future tweets. I can only view his views on music and hockey, but I can no longer speak to the great Ryan Lambert, and I want to take this chance. Ryan, take me back. I so much want to hear your views on Pearl Jam and how every GM, hockey player, coach, stick boy is somehow stupider than you. Because nobody understands the game of hockey or the sport of hockey like you do. Because simply, everybody's so much stupider. I wonder if you would ever grace them with actually going for a GM's or a coach's job or hell, the Zamboni driver. I bet he's pretty stupid too. And I know our relationship got off to a rocky start, Ryan, but come back to me. I so much want to hear what you have to say. I know you'd much rather be writing for Rolling Stone.
Tommy could change for you.
Yeah, I could change for you. You know,
he could do things you couldn't even imagine.
Yes, it's right. I'm absolutely fascinated. I can't respond to your pretentious ass. It's just destroyed me.
So. You're probably fighting for Ryan Lambert to come back more than you fought for your ex-wife.
Yeah, that was definitely I'm leaving and there was a door. That was a door. But that is true that Ryan Lambert is he's blocked me. Because I got drunk one night, and he was writing about Pearl Jam, and I can't even remember what he wrote. And I wrote something to the effect is, actually, I guess I could, I don't know, let's look it up. We have the technology. Here's what he wrote. Oh, no, because he blocked the tweets. Yeah, his account is protected now, so I can't even see what I responded to. It was something like, some Rolling Stone bullshit, like, about Pearl Jam or something like that. And, by the way, I got 2 retweets and 7 favorites out of it. Thank you. And I think about 5 new followers. So I just wrote, I was drunk, and I wrote, who cares, you self-righteous hipster? And then he retweeted it and told everybody that I was in love with him, and I dedicated 3 whole podcasts to him. And that...
You are, though.
I do love him.
He's the wind beneath your wings.
Yes. Maybe it's because I so brutally owned his ass. Maybe he's like, because he's absolutely the living embodiment of a fucking hypocrite. Maybe that has something to do with it. The fact that he blocks me from tweeting to him and pointing out his phoniness, his hypocrisy, yet he wants all the NHL voters that vote on the stupid award show every day to be released publicly so he can do to them what I do to him. Jack off. I think I'm getting over you. You don't want to be criticized. but you want the NHL. He wants the NHL balloters to be public, so he can call them stupid, because that's pretty much what he does. He just calls everybody stupid. Doesn't normally explain it. Everybody's just dumber than him. Yeah, but the fact that he couldn't hold down a jet, he couldn't hold down a Zamboni, he couldn't hold down a jockstrap, he couldn't hold down anything. If you were that fucking smart, Ryan, you'd have the job. And I'm sure it pays more than what Shinsky's giving you or Yahoo's giving you. Because you only write like one fucking article a month, you lazy prick.
Now we're dedicated 4 podcasts to him.
Yeah, going through all the stages like sadness, denial, and anger.
Soon you'll accept it.
I will.
Mm-hmm. You guys start bargaining with him.
No, he hasn't run his brother. Oh, God. I do. I don't even know why. But the simple fact is this. He's just a big pussy. He's a big pussy. He wants, yeah. He thinks he, you know, he can, you know, look below the players and, you know, tell them how stupid they are because they didn't go to college like he did. They didn't learn to write real good like he did. And so he can stand above it. But when a guy like me does the exact same thing that he does to players, GMs, which, by the way, he's probably not that much smarter than. You know, it's not like you're, I can't imagine you getting into a conversation with me about quantum fucking physics and me going, boy, Jesus Christ, that Ryan Lambert's a smart guy. Everybody goes to college nowadays, pal.
Not me.
Nah, me either.
That's right.
Well, I did.
Look at the quality of the show.
Yeah. Well, I got the violin thing in the background.
That's right. Yeah, no, I know. I was actually very impressed by that.
Well, thank you.
Yeah.
You're just a punk, dude. You're nobody.
Yeah.
You're nobody. In fact, if you didn't write everybody was stupid all the time, you probably wouldn't get any attention at all.
You're stupid. They're stupid. Duh, you're dumb.
How smart is that?
That's so stupid.
Something goes wrong in the corporate end of the corporate end of the NHL, and he has to, you know, he's there to stand on the hill above it. Boy, that's so stupid. If I was running it, it wouldn't happen. You know what? Your company's pretty stupid too.
Yeah.
How many screw-ups have they made in the last 20 years?
That's right. Nobody uses Yahoo search engines.
Oh yeah, what happened? You got Googled right the fuck out of your jobs. That used to be the search engine. What happened? Maybe because they have a bunch of hipster reporters in every fucking sport, and they're too painful to read.
The fantasy.
And he doesn't even write. Mooney does. Mooney, Wyshynski, and Leahy do all the work over there. Guy writes one fucking article every 2 months.
Yeah, but it's always the one that upsets you the most.
Yeah, because he's a douche. And I think that's why I want him on Obed. I know I can expose him. And I think he knows that too.
Yeah, or he just doesn't care.
I think he cares. He wouldn't respond to me every time. Who would respond to an idiot like me?
I guess you're saying.
Who would respond to an idiot like me?
I don't know why I do.
Damn good question. A jackass would do that. What a fucking moron. Well, I think we're done with him.
Yeah, Ryan Lambert.
I think we're done with him. You want to hear from Sidney Crosby?
Yeah, I didn't know he has anything going on.
He doesn't, but this is funny. This is when he finds out about, I don't know, this is some ridiculous podcast, probably better than ours. This is him being told about the Metropolitan Division.
I don't know if you know, but the Atlantic Division has been renamed as the Metropolitan Division. You have any thoughts about that?
Is it really?
Yeah, Metropolitan Division.
Really?
And here's the
question. Is it really? No, we're not fucking around, Sid.
I don't like that. It just seems
nobody
so bush
likes
league.
It. And Ryan Lambert thinks it's stupid.
Well, I agree with him on that.
That's true.
I mean, it is. I mean, why would you have Carolina be in the Metropolitan Division?
I don't know.
I don't know if you know, but the Atlantic Division has been renamed as the Metropolitan Division. You have any thoughts about that?
Is it really?
Yeah, Metropolitan Division.
Really?
And here's the confusing
part,
right? Where
does that stem from?
Yeah, that's a really good question, considering Carolina's in it.
Okay, I could see Washington. I could see Columbus. I could see Pittsburgh. I could see Philly. I could see Rangers, Devils, Islanders, all them.
There's only 3 teams in the Metropolitan area. It's the teams by us that we grew up by.
Yeah.
See?
Stupid. Yeah, you're right.
It's stupid. Well,
when the Whalers were there, there was technically four.
Yeah, I guess. Well, they count. Yeah, well, it's Connecticut. You know,
Connecticut's a part of the tri-state area, metropolitan area.
The tri-state metropolitan area.
Yeah.
Come on down to our car lot. We'll get you the lowest prices. I don't miss those.
You missed your calling. You should have been a used car salesman.
Absolutely. That's not enough of a crook. They're stupid. Used car salesman.
Oh God, you gotta listen to. I gotta play the ad for you. The Brad Benson. He has a Hyundai dealership. Brad Benson. He's the. He used to be the offensive lineman for the New York Giants.
Yeah. I think I remember
he that. Has the stupidest commercials.
They all go like, into buying cars.
He's trying to be funny. He's always trying to bring up current events and stuff. It's like he just writes like the hackiest material, and everyone's like, no, just go with it.
Yeah, because he's the boss of the company.
Yeah.
It's like that scene in Wayne's World when the old guy wants to do the commercial for his own stupid arcade.
Yeah.
Yeah. Go ahead, Brad. You're a funny guy. Professional comedian. I really always thought I could do this. Yeah, you can.
It's all like wordplay and like he bought the goalpost from Giant Stadium when they tore it down.
Nice.
And he was like, come see my 40-foot erection. I'm like, ugh. He's like that uncle that you just kind of tolerate. He's always at every party. He's like, oh, Uncle Brad, here he goes. And he's not even that funny. Like, it's just all, like, hack stuff.
I miss those stupid, like, local commercials in New Jersey. I gotta be honest with you. They're,
Should just send you a bunch.
Yeah. But, yeah, they, yeah, I would love to watch. I missed that. Do you remember Crazy Eddie?
Yeah.
God, I love Crazy Eddie. You know what? I'm this is the kind of guy I am. I'm going to put a Crazy Eddie commercial on right now just to let all our Canadian listeners kind of understand like what it was like listening to these stupid commercials. Most people don't know what the fuck we're talking about. But
yeah, like mid-80s.
This is going to be an atypical Crazy Eddie commercial. This is from 1986. I used to love these when I was a kid. Here we go.
Crazy Eddie's greatest TV and video sale ever. Get a video recorder, color TV, large screen TV, video camera, even an audio video component system. Get it all on sale now during Crazy Eddie's greatest TV and video sale ever. Remember, we are not undersold. We will not be undersold. We cannot be undersold. And we mean it. So get anything and everything in TV and video. Get it now during Crazy Eddie's greatest TV and video sale ever. Crazy Eddie, his prices are insane.
You know, it's great about those commercials is it's like, look, I'm mentally ill. Come take advantage of me. I'm selling shit, you know? That's what's so funny about it.
There's this one place in Englishtown. They have they sell furniture. I guess they got the whole entire idea from Crazy Eddie.
Yeah.
But they have signs on it. It says the store price.
Yeah.
And then it has at the bottom in big red magic markers says, the idiot price. I gotta take a picture of that next time.
We don't know what the fuck we're doing.
Yeah, fuck it. We just threw a bunch of numbers there and just.
You know what the best thing is? That family that owned them, I guess they got in trouble with the mob.
Yeah.
The FBI came after them. I remember when I moved to Highland Park. I think his guy's name was Eddie Cantor. Was that his name? I forgot his name. And then he boogied to Israel. He claimed like he got like Meyer Lansky on him. He claimed like he was being persecuted because he was a Jew, and the Israelis like took one look at it. He sent his ass right back, and then his brother like flipped on him, went to the feds, and testified against him. It was hysterical. I mean, you had to figure like even when I was a kid, and I don't know anything about the mob or New Jersey, how crooked New Jersey is. I knew something was up at Crazy Eddie's. You know, them and Tops. That was the other one. Remember Tops over in Edison?
Yeah, wow.
Holy
crap.
Another bunch of crooks. But, yeah, I always liked Crazy Eddie. And, yeah, they sent him right back. He ended up doing some time. And then it was really funny. Like, during the whole controversy, I guess they couldn't call it Crazy Eddie anymore. So they tried to save the company by renaming it, right? And they took that same Crazy Eddie guy. Our prices are insane. And they put, like, a superhero mask on him. and the company was called Guess Who? And he would sit there and do the whole thing. It was, yeah. Yeah. Oh, God.
I wonder why that didn't last too long.
No, that didn't last. It didn't work. But I think the family was just hanging on because you got to figure it's like, you know, some people's entire like fortune was staked in that. Did they have the Guess Who commercial on here? Yeah, they renamed the company. So all the Crazy Eddies started becoming Guess Who's. God, I love Crazy Eddie.
It's hysterical.
Oh, you know my favorite? This is my favorite one. The Christmas in July special. Those are my favorite. They're throwing snowballs around. Here we go.
Hold the mistletoe, because it's a Crazy Eddie Christmas blowout flick. Crazy Eddie's got everything you can possibly need for Christmas, and it's all on sale now. TVs, VCRs, stereo systems, telephones, telephone answering machines, anything and everything in home entertainment, and lots of home appliances, too. Remember, we are not undersold. We will not be undersold. We cannot be undersold, and we mean it. Santa knows that the best deals in town are at Crazy Eddie's during Crazy Eddie's Christmas blowout flick. See Crazy Eddie now. His prices are insane. Hit me. Ha, 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 ha.
Throwing snowballs at him. I wonder if that guy's still alive.
The guy, the Crazy Eddie guy?
Yeah. I wonder if Crazy Eddie's still alive. I wonder if our show's going to be good any next year. Better be better than now.
Oh, God. I'm just looking at it. Oh, my God. Look how old everything was.
Yeah. Well, you're younger. You're like 10 years younger than me. I was probably going to even remember that shit.
I do vaguely. Vaguely remember it, but, you know.
Well, they had it, like, early 90s, so you would have been, like, 9 or 10. I mean, I remember shit when I was 9 and 10 and stuff, so and why wouldn't you? Hell, I remember stuff, like, from, you know, 83 and 84. You know, I was only, like, 5 and 6. I just remember, like, really stupid stuff on television. But Crazy Eddie had to be one of my favorites, hands down. Yeah. So how do you think the show's going to work next year?
Well, maybe if we talk about hockey and not, you know,
not Crazy Eddie,
not commercials from 1982, it might work out good. I think the show's gonna be fun next year.
What we're gonna do is we're gonna take I may do intermittently. We're gonna really scrap the whole news thing. I may do like a monologue in the beginning. That's what I'm thinking. Like for the latest news stories and hope desperately tie them into. Sort of the lighter stuff that we do in hockey.
Everything hockey. We do, like all of our video stuff, is all news stuff anyway.
Yeah,
you know, true. It's all.
But I hate to. We're gonna cover most of the. And I gotta be honest with you. What I want to do is, and this is coming from Joe Cronin. I still want to do like an hour and a half podcast, right? But what I'm gonna do is that's gonna be for the hardcore. I'm gonna chop it up. Like some of our best, like sort of like we do the best of, and maybe like a 10-minute chop up. Like we did one really funny bit. We'll chop it up and we'll make that a separate video, and then we'll put a thumbnail in there to confuse the fuck out of everybody and make it something else, make it look like a video, and then try to trap them that way. That's what Joe Cronin was telling me. It did too.
Oh yeah, no.
Like he puts a picture. Like he'll talk about some WWE Raw crap that he's watching on TV. He'll talk about that, and then. He'll put a thumbnail. It'll look like, oh, the video's there. And you go in there, and it's fucking Joe screaming about sticking nails in people's eyes and shit. You know?
I actually played Xbox with him, like, a few weeks back.
How'd that go? Did he beat your ass?
No, like, we were on the same team. I suck at the online, like, just, like, you know, like, play with...
Yeah, because you play with the 94 controls. Of course you do.
No, I don't play with the... No, it's not the 90... It's not the... I'm good at, like, head-to-head. Yeah. But this is like with the, you know, when like you actually have your own player.
Oh, like, yeah. You have to. I haven't done. See, I'm waiting for next year because I want to pay for all that shit now.
You don't have to pay for it.
Yeah, you do. You got to pay for the season thing, don't you?
No, you don't have to. You just go and drop in games.
Yeah, I don't even know how to do that.
You just go, into the EA community.
I want to play defense. That's what I'm really into now. Because I'm still over 500.
Oh, yeah. I'm good in like head to head. It's the other.
I play, like, really, because I can't do any, like, moves or offense. So I just play really, really tight defense and wait for you to turn over the puck. And then I just throw wicked wrist shots at the net.
Just I mean, a lot of the time, him and I just talked about, like, the show and stuff. Mm. I told him, like, your idea for Shirley Phelps Roper.
What?
Remember we were talking about getting Shirley Phelps Roper, the Westboro Baptist Church, and just asking her a bunch of hockey questions?
Yeah, ask her a bunch of – and then the you can play thing. Oh, God. That's a for those who don't know, that's the God Hates Fags Lady. And I'm not saying fags because I can get away with saying fags. I'm saying it because that's like, is it the organization? No, it's called the Westboro Baptist Church, right?
Yeah, but when you just say it's just the God Hates Fags Lady.
God Hates Fags Lady. Yeah, I figure we pepper with a bunch of questions about the You Can Play project.
And then just, yeah, so do you think Ovechkin should have won the Hart Trophy? Stuff like that. We will try and make this happen for next season.
If your kid got a $100 million or a $10 million contract to play hockey for the New York Rangers, would you let him play? And if for God some reason she said yes, he goes, but what about the You Can Play project? Would you let him play that?
She'd probably just quote some scripture.
Oh, that's cool. That would be great. Yeah, and she'd probably go along with it, wouldn't she?
Yeah, she'll go on anything. You could just call her up.
I guess she thinks that's her like religious duty, just to face gays all the time, right?
Yeah, exactly. And even if to go on to our show, that's like our show. Yeah, that's all I can say.
I tell you, I get a lot more people listen to because they are not popular in the military.
Oh yeah,
they are not a popular crew.
Yeah,
there's not much you can do about them. That's the problem.
Yeah.
Without going into a police state.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, Howard Stern used to have her on. God.
I know.
But she'll go. But he had her on like years ago, like when I think he was on the Channel 9 show or something. He'd had her on for a long time.
She was on everything. She even went on one of my shows.
She has like an illegitimate kid, right?
Her first child was born out of wedlock.
She didn't talk about. You brought that up too, right?
Yeah, and she just started going scriptures and.
Is he gay?
One of our kids, I think, left the church.
Not good for him. Yeah, left the church and right into a psychiatry office.
Yeah.
Jesus, can you imagine growing up in that?
I don't know. It's great. It's funny. My I have a friend. She lives in Kansas City, like right on the outskirts of Kansas City, Belton. She told me she actually saw like two guys on a motorcycle at Westboro Baptist Church patches on their jacket. I was like, oh my God. It's like, please. He's like, you must have had like every piece of self-control to not just run them off the road, you know?
I know. God. That's such a handful bunch. All right. Let's get to hockey.
Yeah.
A few things here. The New York Rangers have recently been given 10 years to move to another location.
Yes, the Quebec Rangers.
Right. You know, first of all, it's not going to happen, and it's a joke. And all the Rangers have to do is say, okay, we're moving to New Jersey. Okay, we're going to move somewhere else, like out of the city, and that is the end.
Rangers.
The vote was like 47 to 1. We should interview the one guy. Were you just trying to be different? I mean, what a bunch of jackasses. I mean, look, MSG can dictate terms to them. Because, like my dad said, all you got to do is Steinbrenner their ass. All right, fine, we'll go. They'll stop everything.
You know what would be great? It's like, if they said, all right, well, they're all going away party for you.
I got news for you. They'll
I don't think it would happen, but.
Yeah.
I mean, hell, they're giving fucking Detroit a new stadium.
Yeah.
And Detroit's bankrupt.
Yeah. That tells you everything you need to know about the guy who runs our country. And if you're saying to yourself, you're such an idiot. Obama doesn't run Detroit. He's the president. Well, his policies and that type of thinking got Detroit in the mess they are in now.
Detroit was
going bankrupt. We're screwing all our fucking creditors. But we're going to come up with $444 million for the goddamn new Joe Louis Arena. How does that make sense?
I don't know.
That's why the economy shit. Because they keep not making sense. They spent something like $100 million more dollars than they took in every year for the last 10 years.
I think it's something like almost 50% of all buildings in Detroit are abandoned.
So 50, and there's like, this is shocking. I didn't know this. There's under 1 million people living there. It's unbelievable. It's an American city, for Christ's sakes. It's the pride of the nation. George Bush's fault.
Yeah,
I'm watching this asshole on CNBC. or MSNBC, and he's like, this is what brought Detroit to its knees is the Republicans' small government policies. There hasn't been a Republican elected there since before the fucking Second World War. Unbelievable. And they're still going to come up with the money because there's something's happened to our society. One plus one doesn't equal two anymore for some reason. In fact, two minus, well, I don't want to get, there's no such thing as negative. Negative zero, negative one, negative two. For some reason, and I don't know where it came along, you can go over budget. It's like these guys, you know, we have a country. I used to know these guys, like, in high school, that they wouldn't pay their cell phone bill. And, you know, after, like, 2 months, they'd shut the fucking thing off. And these guys would throw a shit fit. A fucking shit fit.
We've all woken up in the cables. Like,
they can't do that. You can't do that. And, I used to think, well, you know, this is my idiot friend Joe. You know, not Sienna, by the way. This is my idiot friend Joe. You know, it's a good thing. He won't grow up to run the country. Well, he probably, apparently he did.
Hey, but you know, we've all woken up and, oh shit, the cable's out.
Yeah, but I didn't blame anybody.
I know, no, I blame myself. I'm like, they were serious with those phone calls.
I didn't call. I mean, like, what's that conversation going to be like? Hey, you shut off my cell phone. Yeah, you missed three payments and you got five warnings. Yeah. You can't do that. Well, the fuck, we can't pass, motherfucker. In fact, we'll see you in small claims court. How come that doesn't apply to our government? How can we defraud all those bankers? Let me tell you something. Here's who I don't feel sorry for. Is those fucking pensioners. You're the type of thinking that created this mess. You think there's an unlimited amount of money. It's just there.
The bailout that Obama gave them, they didn't create any new jobs. Well, they did, but they're all outsourced.
Yeah, sure.
You know?
Work great, huh? Well, they'll get a new stadium. You know what? You know what our country needs? A couple bridge collapses. And you think I'm being cruel. That's exactly what's going to have to wake everybody up. Coming out of Minnesota, we've just lost 200 people to a sudden bridge collapse. It's strange because it was investigated last Tuesday by our bridge officials.
It's not going to happen here because all three bridges are being worked on that go from New Jersey into New York. Into
what if they
Staten
can't
Island?
Pay those guys anymore? You know what they do? They walk off the fucking job.
Yeah.
That's the problem. There's not an unlimited amount of money. Oh, we'll just take it from fucking rich people. Till when? Oh, well, they do it in Europe. Europe's falling apart. And the only reason Greece hasn't declared bankruptcy is because the EU won't let them. Which is probably illegal, because the EU shouldn't have any authority over a bankruptcy declaration. And some judge some left-wing judge nut tried that in Detroit. Like, you can't declare bankruptcy. Fucking who's got the authority to say they can't declare bankruptcy? There's no fucking money!
Hey, Tommy, I just thought of something.
What?
If the Rangers did have to move, would you become like a Quebec Rangers fan?
It's not going to Quebec. I got news for you.
The Atlanta Rangers.
They go to Long Island before they get that.
The Atlanta Rangers.
The Atlanta Rangers. Stop trying to get me off of politics. I'm angry.
The Kansas City Rangers.
I'd say I'd be a Detroit Red Wings fan. I always said I'd do that, but I don't know.
They're going to be the Quebec Red Wings.
Nobody.
Everybody's going to Quebec. Any team that has any financial problems, yeah.
Let's go to a city that 20 years ago couldn't support a hockey team of their own. That's a great idea. Quebec. Let's go to another city
Rangers.
In Seattle that we have no real testing ground to really know if it's going to work or not.
Yeah.
Let's put another team in Atlanta for the second time and watch it fail.
The Halifax Rangers.
I sound like Ryan Lambert. Actually, that's one thing we agree on. They're building a new stadium. They're trying to build a new stadium. Don't worry, Ed. And they're saying, it's because we need jobs. It's because you need jobs. You can't pay your own workers.
They said something like 40% of the streetlights work in Detroit, too.
That's great. Good. You deserve it. All you people
today, all you pensioners,
all you people that suck so much out of your fucking the car companies over there, all you self-entitled pricks that think there's nothing but money and there's no consequences for continuing to tax and spend and chase all the people with money out of your city, good. You need a little bridge collapse and some starvation to wake the fuck up.
I think the Detroit Red Wings logo should just be the bankrupt sign from Wheel of Fortune.
Yeah,
that should be their goal horn.
Hold on a second. Let me see if I get that. Wheel of Fortune bankrupt sound. Here we go. Oh, isn't this one? Here we go. Here we go. 1, 2, 3.
Hell, debts, and scars!
This is from 1976-1989. Here we go. And debts, and scars! Oh. Detroit.
The Detroit's new goal horn.
Here it is. The new Joe Louis Arena. The new Joe Louis released a little goal horn. There it is. Jackasses. Starve to death. Starve to death.
They don't have a major supermarket. Starve to death. Either.
Starve to death till you realize there is a science to economics. And denying economics is like denying evolution for all you fucking liberals out there. Jackasses.
Play that goal horn one more time.
You're such a fucking prick. It's not funny. Oh. That's who scores. Oh, I didn't hate when they did that. I remember, like, my grandmother used to watch Wheel of Fortune, right? And you know, she would sit there and when they, you know, they used to go, oh, like the whole place goes, oh. So I thought it'd be really funny next time it happens to laugh out loud. My grandmother had a canary. How could you say that? They just lost all their money.
Sounds like my grandma.
That's evil. No, she didn't say that's evil. She said something like you should go to church. Bless me, Father, for I had sinned. This is my first confession. I laughed at the woman who couldn't get the final letter because she had every other single letter up there to solve the puzzle when the bankrupt sound came. I laughed out loud. Grandma was mad. Grandma was mad, you know.
Speaking of game shows that come on ABC at 7 and 7:30, every time you watch Jeopardy and Room Full of People, yeah, everybody just tries to be more smart than everybody else in that room.
Sure. Sure. Hey, what are you going to do if I get a new job next year?
What's that?
The times are different. I'm trying to get a new job. Might affect us.
Oh, no.
So far, it hasn't happened, so don't worry about it. It might affect us. All right. Yeah. Here comes the big part of the show. I've been avoiding this for months, and it's finally time to get through it. As you know, Jake is not the only host of the show, and he was not the starting host. The first one host was Dead On Dave Van Cura, and Dead On Dave has went on to two other shows, and he got us here involved within the Podbender network, which me and Jake are totally thrilled about. And we want to be able to contribute any way we can. You know, when the move's done and the weddings are done, the summer's over and the season starts, we definitely want to start contributing more. But we haven't had such a good start as far as, I don't know, I consider myself, you know, a team player. You know, I talk to Jake during the week all the time. About what we're gonna do, and you know, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. What the hell, you know? I mean, we can't all be winners, right, Jake?
Yeah, no.
No, we can't all be winners. Yeah, see?
That's those poor people in Detroit.
Anyway, boy, it's a lot harder than I thought it was gonna be. I basically, Dave's done some shows recently where he's mentioned me, Michelle, and our situation that I have to address. And it's 3 points of contention that I'm going to go over with you right now. The first and foremost, Dave is no longer on the show. So, and we never really went on to any kind of information about it or explanation because I didn't think it was necessary. And the idea for last season was to have a rotating guest anyway. It just turned out that Jake, when I'm just going to go through these real quick. I wrote kind of 3 bullets down, and I just want to correct some things that have been said on the Podbender Network. Dave, contrary to popular belief, and was never kicked off of our show. Not once, not twice. He was never, ever kicked off. He opted out, then came back, then showed a lack of motivation and interest. When he started going flaky on me, I asked Jake to fill the roles. I remember the conversation clearly. I said, look, I don't know where Dave stands. I don't want to be like kind of chasing him down or what have you. I was like, you think you kind of give me just more of an effort? And Jake agreed to it, and he is more than fulfilled the role. And I'm really happy with him, and he is now the permanent co-host for that reason. Yeah. Now, let me go back to he was not kicked off the show. Here's what really happened. In October of last year, I was doing a show with Dave called This Guy's Take on It. And during one of those shows, we got an argument. And it was, one of these stupid-ass nerdy arguments that probably would be the best radio ever. It'd probably be a complete fucking scream over... it wasn't even... Well, that's my point. That's my second bullet. I have never, not once, flipped out over Seth MacFarlane. That was recently mentioned on A Nerd and a Jerk. And what happened was during this show, I made a crack about Seth MacFarlane and how I didn't like the show, which is the reason I thought I was supposed to be on the show. I was supposed to, like, goof on the stuff because I really don't get involved in a lot of pop culture things. And Dave, I don't remember exactly what he said, but he suggested something to the effect, like, that I was insensitive and he was quite serious and what have you. And then he just, like, and moving on. And I took exception to that. I said, look, you can't do that to me. At least let me explain. And it was like he said something to the effect of, well, some of the listeners don't really appreciate. And I was just something. I was like, well, all three of them? And it completely disintegrated into sort of an argument. And it had more to do with me, him kind of like stepping over. And I'll be perfectly honest, I don't remember. It was that long ago. It was stepping over me and then trying to constantly change the subject. When I was like, I felt like, I was kind of challenged, and then the floor was pulled out, the rug was pulled out from under me before I could respond to it, and that's really was the whole point of contention. If you don't believe me, last February, Dave told me he had those tapes. I told him to air them, it should be a riot, right? Air them. I didn't flip out over you flipped out, not me. You can air the tapes. You're more than welcome. And what happened after that was when the lockout happened, we had I fully expected Dave to come back because, we had ironed that out and whatever, because it really wasn't that big a deal. And a few guys on Facebook asked me if we're going to do Shot from the Point again, and I wasn't. I thought we'd kind of ended it. And I heard so many things, and my girlfriend said she was going to get Game Center and all this other stuff. I was like, you know what? Let's do it again. And then... I went to Dave, first person I went to, and I said, you want to do that? And he hemmed and hawed and edged. I don't know. It might work. It may end up like last time. I was like, first of all, who cares if it lasts? That'd be a fucking riot. Second of all, I'm asking you, do you want to do it or don't you want to do it? Because I'll start asking around. He says, nah, I don't think it's going to work. And I said, that's fine. So I contacted Jersey Jason. I contacted Jake, and we started again. And... slowly, we kind of developed to what we pretty much were by the end of the season. By the end of Jake's show, the second one, Dave had been in contact with me, and he said, I think I want to come back. And I said, Absolutely. Right? And if I'm not mistaken, he was on episode 3 and 4. Is that right, Jake?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, he was on episode 3 and 4, right? And I remember episode 3 being really, really fun. But I had promised, I think, episode 5 to Jake. I'd already, like, given him a slot. And then when I kept my promise, there was just sort of I said, well, when do you want to be on again? I could really see the dejection in his voice. And he was just like, well, you know, you can take me whenever you want to take me and what have you. You can, you know, do what you want. Just call me if you need me. I was like, no, I don't want that. I go, I want to slot this, and I want a weekly readout. So, one of the things I didn't like about Shot from the Point in 2012 is because it was just all improv all the time. At least we had a date to release. We had a plan. We had somewhat of an outline. And then after that, it was kind of improv during the show. And that's... And Dave really wasn't interested. And I don't really want somebody that's going to be like, yeah, you can take me if you need. You can drag me out. And, you know, this victimization crap. And I was just like, I don't know what to tell you. You can be back on if you want. And if I had to guess, and I don't know what's going through Dave's head, he was pissed off that I told Jake that I wanted him back. And I didn't want Jake back to replace Dave. That was no – what happened was when we started it again – he had the opportunity. He turned it down. He said he didn't want to do it. I put two other guys. I promised people the other one, and I couldn't drop them. I couldn't do it. So Dave was never given his walking papers. Dave was never told, you're not allowed. None of it. None of it's true. Dave was never given his walking papers. And it really aggravates me when I listen to his show, which is spammed 1,000 times every 2 seconds on Facebook, and I hear this stuff. It drives me nuts. Dave was always invited back. Dave was invited back in the final show of the season. So none of that's true. And I didn't flip out over Seth fucking MacFarlane. I've seen about 3 episodes of Family Guy my whole life. Fuck Seth MacFarlane. Sorry it hurt your feelings. Don't care. But anyway, and the thing that really... ticked me off more than anything. And the reason I've let this go one after another. I mean, Jake knows that I've been talking about with him and how much it's bothering me. Well, there's another thing. I asked him to come back and play the game this year. He sends, and Jake can verify this, he sends a note and he says, I don't know, I haven't been on the show. All he wanted to do is make picks. So we get in this big fucking lecture argument over him not being on the show. And I said, you can always come back, but you just got to give me a time and a date. And then we can work with together. Oh, that doesn't work with me. You shouldn't have to do that. I said, fine. You don't want to play. You don't want to be on. That's fine. Right? And then he writes me, well, I really don't like those types of games anyway. Even though what he told me was because it would be weird because he was on the show. And by the way, I have all these I have all these texts. Right? And the final thing that ticked me off the most, because now I'm actually really upset about this, because I'm on this new network. And everybody thinks I'm a fucking shitbag. If you listen to Dave, you think I was a shitbag that flips out over nerd crap and stands people up. Dave told Jake on the last show that the week prior, he would have had a guest, but somebody that you and me both know stood him up. I've never stood Dave up once. I was never invited in the show, and there's nothing he can show that I was ever invited on the show, except after we did our final, I was invited on, and I said I'd do it, and I asked him to give me a date and time, which got into a lecture about how we don't work this way, and you give me a time, or what have you. And I'll tell you, the reason I didn't give him a time is because when I got the time from him in the past, he's asleep, or he's in pain, which actually isn't his fault, or he changes his mind, and I end up sitting my whole day with my thumb up my ass. So I told him, you give me a time. And that was one of the points of contention with the other thing. You know, that he didn't want to do this kind of time. Well, I need to be on a time schedule. I was never demanding about it. And now he's telling people I stood him up and stand anybody up. The only thing I've ever done was after he asked me to be on the show, after we did the last one of the season, after we got in another stupid argument on Facebook, which I'm, by the way, I'm happy to post all of this when the on-demand version comes out. Happy to be posting all of this stuff. tired of it. That I finally got sick of the lecture, and I contacted him. I was like, look, I don't think I want to do this. And then he wrote me back. I was just calling to cancel you anyway. That's not standing anybody up. And stand Dave up. I didn't kick him off the show, and I don't freak out over little stuff. And if you don't believe me, you can look at your screens right now if you're watching the on-demand version, and you can see our notes, my notes between me and Dave. He was never not invited on. He just wouldn't stick to a schedule. And to be perfectly honest with you, when we got in that argument in October, he said this to me: you're only doing this to me because you have power over me, and if you don't come on, you know nobody will, so you're using this. I said, no, Dave, I don't not want to be on. Well, and then he says to me, well, we're not working together anymore. And I said, okay, Dave. I didn't even quit. I was fired. I was told I wasn't on. Allowed on. So what Dave tried to do is, when we tried to put the show together, he pulled back. And he thought his plan would work, that I'd come running back to him, and I didn't. I just called somebody else. And when I called somebody else and they were on, that made him insane. So when we came back on, we did a really good show. Now I'm in a rotational basis. I can't tell all these people that I made promises to that they can't be on. That's it. I've been waiting to get this off my chest for months. I don't stand people up. I've been during the time that he wasn't talking or not doing, he did a podcast and he didn't do one for too much. I said, I was like, look, we're doing best of. You want to be involved? Do you want to be involved in this? Want? Oh no, 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 no. What can I do? There's nothing I can friggin' do. And now he's telling people I'm standing up. Didn't stand him up. And you know what? The only contact I had with him on Facebook that had anything to do with the show happened in June, not 2 weeks ago. Happy to put that up there too. Don't believe me on the Seth MacFarlane thing? Dave, air the tapes. You have them. You told me you have them unless they disappeared. Air the tapes. So I don't want to go into this new network and sound like I'm a tool to my friend. I didn't do it. I'm denying it. And I'm going to leave it at that. No fucking radio. What are you laughing at, fuckface?
There's a fight going on my new Facebook picture I posted.
Over what?
I posted, we took a team photo of my the softball team.
Yeah.
And I made it my Facebook post. And there's one, my one friend said, the dude next to you looks pretty cute. Yeah, when I zoom in.
Yeah.
I said, haha, that's Carlos. She goes, with the yellow thing and the sunglasses? I go, yeah. She goes, yeah, I'm not talking about that Mexican to your left. Ew. And his brother, who's on my softball team, just said, Mexican, your ass, loser.
Oh, jeez. Is that going to be like a big war? Is that like legit? Are they going to fight now?
It's like this girl, Terry, and Kevin, who's on my softball team. So I was like, oh, God. Now I'm going, oh, God, I didn't think posting this pic would start a fight.
Yeah. God, I don't like you put on Trayvon Martin up there. Well, anyway, that's your problems. And I've been looking to get this shit off my chest for a while.
I've heard it so many times.
I'm glad you're not going to hear any more, because now I got it off my chest. I didn't stand anybody up. I didn't kick anybody off. Dave opted out. And he opted out for the worst of reasons. He opted out to be manipulative. And I just, look, I grew up in a Catholic family. I know all this bullshit. And I know getting in a big fucking screening match is the last thing I want to do. And that, first of all, you can't win that way. So when somebody says to me, I don't know, Tommy, I don't know. You know what? Okay, fine. That's what I did. So when that didn't work, you know, if he really wanted to be the host of A Shot from the Point, if he wanted to be the co-host for A Shot from the Point, he'd have been here. And then he got flaky on me, and then I took somebody permanently. He left. And you know what? That's fine. He's got like 14 shows. There's nothing wrong with that. But I can't go onto this new network thinking I'm a type of guy that sticks kicks off my friend, sticks it in his ass, and stands him up. The whole reason I was asking for a time, because that's what I was afraid of. What's wrong with asking for a fucking time? That's it. For his show. For his show. That's it. That's all I wanted. And I've been biting my tongue with this shit because I don't want some stupid radio war. And I got to be honest with you, I really don't care how Dave responds to that, because I'm not going to respond to it again. I was talking to one of our listeners a couple months ago, and I was venting on this shit. He goes, you have a liability on your hand. That's the problem. It's a liability. I mean, I can't do shows where I'm worried. I can say Jake's fat, and he's a fuckface, and come off like this and make fun of his teams. With Dave, I never knew if he was going to blow up or get his feelings hurt. That's not what we're doing over here. You got to have a thick skin. You have to have a thick skin. And you know what? If you really listen to that tape, it's not me with the thin skin, and I invite you to play it. It would be a fucking riot. A fucking riot. You know, whenever I did those shows, and I'm not saying I always did a good job. I tried my hardest. But I'd go to Dave and I'd say, look, what do you want from me? He would say, do what you want. Give me whatever you want. Well, you know, I was thinking about doing, like, you know, the shock jock kind of obnoxious thing and make funny what you're doing. Well, yeah, if you want. And then I'd do it, and then he'd get pissed off. Saying I was trying to take over a show. I didn't know what else to do, and he wouldn't give me any direction. And then the one time that I thought that I'd be helping his View for the Cow show, his second podcast, right, I overdid it and overplayed my hand because I wanted so fucking much for his show to be good and him to be happy with it. I tried so goddamn hard, and it sucks, I'll be honest with you, and it's all my fault, I'll be honest with you. But that's not my style. That's not what I can do. I don't even know if I can do this right. I'm not going to get in a fucking conversation about television and Dungeons and Dragons. It just doesn't interest me. It doesn't even cross my radar through my day. I don't care. I don't fucking care about it. I think it's funny to goof around, but that's about it. Everybody's entitled to like whatever they want to like. But I have no connection with it. Sorry I couldn't help you. But nobody threw you out. Nobody stood you up, and I don't appreciate my character coming into connection. I'm trying to make a good impression on Tremonti with our work.
Yeah, definitely.
That's really what I spoke about. Because you've been running your mouth for the last. He's running your mouth the last 2 months. 2 months ago, he said, "Well, I can't talk about hockey anymore." He never called me once and said he wanted to be on. He wants me to call him. And when I did call him, he was flaky about it. And when he got flaky about it, I went to somebody else. Didn't lecture him, didn't throw him off the show, didn't make a big scene, didn't make fun of him, didn't do any of that shit. Just found somebody else, like a grown-up would, I would think. That's what I did. What's your fucking opinion?
Honestly, I've been hearing it for so long and just,
you heard it on the air now.
Huh?
You heard it on the air now.
Yeah, I know, but it just kind of like, what's the word? It's just become so, you know.
It's boring the balls off you, can be honest.
Yeah, you know. Hell, I changed my Facebook picture and got into my own argument.
Now, I let this go for months. You know what? He could have said what it just about. He could have goofed on me. But, you know, this is character stuff. And if he's going to fucking pull the trick where, oh, Tommy, I was just kidding. You fell for it. Ha, 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 ha. Well, I invite anybody to go back and listen to that shit and figure out that he's joking. That I'm not allowed to go on a show anymore. That I stood him up last week. I didn't talk to him last week, especially about a show. In fact, the only thing I do is I hear that constant spamming. Spamming. On his page, on the Podbender stuff. Hell, you know what this guy did to my girlfriend? He wrote one of these, like, chain letters where, like, hi, and, like, fill in the blank, Andy, could you share this show with me over and over? My girlfriend!
I got that, too.
And yeah, you got it, too. It wasn't a personal message. It was a fucking commercial. Don't do that. I put a fucking separate page up so I don't have to pester my friends. And I'm the scumbag? I'm standing people up. I haven't been invited to be on A View from the Couch since June. And then when you asked me in the last show, when I went up, all I did is give you time. And all this stuff is going to be, I'm going to take pictures of this, and I'm going to put it up there. And then I got a lecture. And then the same thing I had when I was in the show. I had to walk on a friggin' ice sheet not to hurt your feelings. Never embarrassed you in the air. Never called you out. Never did any of that stuff. All stuff I could have done. Edit it out when you look stupid. Yet, when I edit out a joke from you and not a joke from friggin' Jake, then I got to hear about it later. That's fine. You don't like what you want, you do your own show. Don't be telling people that I'm standing you up. It's bullshit. It's not true. There's no truth to it. And you couldn't possibly put out any evidence to such. I could put out evidence of backing up what I just said. But there's no evidence that I never did not want you on the show. There is no evidence of whatsoever. It's absolutely 150% not true. And I'm sorry things worked out. But you know what? I thought it would be better. He's more interested in Chicago sports and kind of the international and golf and all this other stuff and all the nerdy stuff and what he calls geekery and stuff like that, which really started on Shot from the Point. We used to do something called Geekery News, and I goofed on it. So you should be happy. You're more than welcome to come back on, but you try to play games. Oh, I don't know, Tommy. I don't know. This is going to work. We don't work together well. Jake comes on. Oh, come on. And then 2 weeks later, I promised Jake he'd be on this week. Well, you can, if you ever need me again, just let me know. I was like, well, do you want to be on next week or the week after Jake's on? Yeah, just let me know. Well, I think Jake wants to do it again. Do you just give me, well, you could just bring me if he cancels or what have you. Oh, don't give me that Catholic fucking guilt horse shit. I grew up with it. Grew up with all of it. I know every trick. And you know what the trick is? Pretend it's not happening. Say, okay, sure. I'm not manipulated that easy. I'm not that stupid. So when somebody does that to me, I just go along with it. When I get passive-aggressive horseshit, I just go along with it. Yeah, sure. Whatever you want, man. Because you want to be on the show, you could have been on the show. You could have been on show 1, 2, 3, 4, all the way to 23. And now it is over. You're absolutely right, Jake. And I'm glad I got it out. But to the new Podbender folks, to anybody's listening, I didn't do that. And I wouldn't do that. I'm a team player. And I think Jake thinks he's been fairly treated.
Yeah, I do.
It's not like we're doing this for money. We're totally amateurs. It's not that fucking serious. We're not A-list people. Shit, we're not even Z-list people.
I am.
Nah, fuck you. Just want to talk about hockey and joke around about it. That's it. That's the idea. Make dumb videos. Hopefully take off. And you know what? Even if we don't, we make great friends. We make great friends in Canada. We make great friends in Boston with Joe Cornyn. And hopefully we make more good friends in Boston and help. Because this shit doesn't work unless you help somebody. And I can't have somebody going on their airwaves and saying stuff that isn't true. And I tell you something. If he comes back and says, oh, I was just kidding. Ha, 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 ha. Well, let me tell you something. If it was a joke, when you told Jake I stood you up, you should have went on there and had the responsibility to say, I was just kidding. He didn't stand me up. No, what would he call me? He called me a jerk bag or some shit like that. And then he said, oh, just kidding. More passive-aggressive horse shit.
Huh.
Goof on me all you like. I don't give a shit about that. You started attacking my character. Which, by the way, I think was the actual argument with the Seth MacFarlane thing. It was a character issue. Fuck Seth MacFarlane.
I like Seth MacFarlane.
He sucks. Dungeons and Dragons sucks. Tolkien sucks. It all sucks. If you like it, it sucks. Sorry you don't think that's funny. It's stupid. Ask Larry Lambert.
I don't care.
And by the way, this is not some fucking radio war. If Dave goes off on a fucking rant or what have you, guess what? I'm going to do exactly what I do when he's passive-aggressive. I'm going to just go with it. Yeah, sure, Dave, you're right. That's exactly what I'm going to do if you start a radio war. I'm not going to acknowledge it. Same thing I do when you say, oh, Tommy, oh, no. I don't know if this is going to work. I'm going to say, okay, Dave, if it doesn't going to work, that's fine. That's it. End story? You agree?
Yeah.
That's it. I don't see any reason to talk about this unless some fucking stupid-ass lies come out.
Are you going to post it to him?
Post it. It's on live now. This goes on right afterwards. I'm going to edit it tomorrow, and I'm going to put those conversations in the higher quality version that's recording right now.
Nice.
That's what I'm going to do. I'll put the conversations in. That's it.
Tommy the cyber bully.
I'm not bullying anybody. I want to go into this network. I want to start on the right foot. I can't be finding people that I flip out over fucking cartoons and stand my friends up. I can't have that. And if you go back on, oh, I was just kidding. Bullshit. You're being passive aggressive like you normally are. Now you got your radio war. Congratulations. And guess what? When you come back, I don't care what you say. I'm not going to even answer it. Because it couldn't be less than stupider. Or, you know what I mean. Don't care. You know what time it is?
It's plug time.
You sound relieved. Hey, listen, fuckface. Speak now or forever hold your peace.
Well, let's plug.
That's not what I mean, you fucker.
Speak now? What do you mean?
Yeah, if you have any, if I'm out of line here, I want to hear it.
No, I don't think you are. I mean, you pretty much have told me, and everything you've said to me hasn't been a lie.
Yeah. I don't know. They don't owe it. I never got into it. And now he finally ran me out my hole. Tired of it. Dumb.
Stupid.
And now it's over. Do what you want with it. Play the clips in your show. You left.
Yep.
That's it. You got your Ryan Lambert role. Come on, man. Congratulations. Go plug your shit. I want to get the fuck out of here.
I have nothing going on. Softball's over. We lost.
No, it's
I might start hockey. I don't have any shows coming up.
No.
Nothing to plug.
Well, it's like the worst time of year. And the reason we're doing this show is get ready. This is going to be the last summer show, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure. The last one. And then you're going to get singing.
Yeah.
Podbender. We are a part of
Podbender. Yes.
Podbender. We're a part of the Pod Bender Network. And some of the shows you can find on Podbender is The Skinny with Mike and Adam. And sometimes
and
Dave.
Big
Soul Crushing Radio. So with Soul Crushing Radio with special guests this week, Dave. Rhyme and Treason Pirate Radio, which Dave will soon be appearing on. Nerd and the Jerk with Dave Bancura. Devil's Advocate with Dave. Podbender. Enjoy Podbender. Endless amounts of Dave.
I'm trying to get my one friend show on there. It's called Naughty Bits. It's with Heather Height, very funny comic.
You know, I know a great guest they could have on. Dave.
she has porn stars and stuff, so I think she's been in contact with them.
I'm sure Dave knows everything about porn stars you could possibly imagine. All the way from 1975 to 2003. Dave Bender.
That's right. Dave from the Point.
Dave from the Point. Dave and the Jerk. Dave.
That's
a
right.
View from Dave. And a view from the couch. And a blog.
Uh-huh. Dave on the couch.
Dave on the couch.
Dave crushing radio.
Dave crushing radio. Hey, you know, there's a really good blog here. They do blogs on Podbender as well. And the last one's from Dave! And there's this book called The Chronicles of L.J. Stevens that he's actually, I guess he's letting you read it for... Oh, guess who wrote it? Dave! Friend Dave on Facebook today and have him spam your girlfriend in a phony message to help you because you're his friend, even though you wrote the message to absolutely everybody and you only changed the name of the person each time. Dave Bender. Endless amounts of Dave.
You want your share of Dave Bancura? You got it.
You want your share of Dave?
That's right. Dave is like the Gordon Ramsay. Well, Gordon Ramsay is the Fox.
I don't know that
joke.
Yeah,
that's right. You're German. That reference. Gordon Ramsay. He's a English chef. He's like very big on the BBC, and like he has like three shows. He has shows where, like where he goes around exposing like dirty restaurants.
Oh,
and
wow.
Then he has a show like where you have a chance to win a top of the line. You know, restaurant, and then he also has another one where he takes home cooks and called Master Chef.
I think I heard Dave talk about that once. He knew all about it. We were going to talk about it last week, but I stood him up because I'm like that, bitch. Dave Bender.
We're gonna get kicked off.
I don't give a shit. To be perfectly honest with you.
We had a good
run. We had a good run on Podbender. You know what? Honestly, I could care less. I want to be a part of the team, what have you. And this is how I respond to this kind of shit. And you know what? From now on, I'm going to respond to it like this. Except for Dave, because we're done. This is what I do. I attack reporters. And if somebody's going to run around on a new network that I'm supposed to make a good impression on, telling me I'm standing up, that's like the worst thing you can say about somebody. He stood you fucking up. He didn't ask me to be on. He wanted to tell people that I was a prick. And then, if I called him out on it, he could say, oh, I was just kidding. And as long as I didn't respond to it, he was going to continue to do it. And that was the final decision for this. Because it's been going on for months. You know, I could have got back on the shot before. Hey, Tom, can I be on this week? Because that's the last thing I told. Couldn't show interest, so I found somebody else. Now he's got 15 shows in his own network.
I think they'd let us have a piece of it.
Yeah. Cool. Dave Ben. Hey, Tremonti. What's it like sitting there for an hour and a half and going to one random subject after another? Tough to stay awake, huh?
Oh, yeah. I'm looking up all the other...
Go from Dungeons & Dragons to Game of Thrones, the fucking Family Guy, back down to the Chicago Cubs.
The Dave's Advocates. David the Jerk.
Dave Ben and David the Jerk. Shot for Pink. I like that one.
Generation Dave Cast. There's one called Shit Rick Says that we call Shit Dave Says. The Higher Side Chats with the Higher Side Dave.
Yeah, last week on Podbender. Hey, if you're going to go out, let's go out in a flame of fucking bullets. I really got no problem with Tremonti, but let me tell you something. I hope you can handle it all. I did my best. I was as good a friend as I could be. Good luck.
The Podbender After Party, which could be now the Podbender After Dave.
After Dave, you go.
The Chronicles of LJ Dave. DJI Dave Mizzle. Bango and Dave. Legal Dave. That's legal disclaimers. Audible.Dave offers.
We really do want to be in the network. But there's no fucking way somebody's going to do this to me without answering. It's just not happening.
Well, I'm looking at the forum. Welcome guest posting in this forum. Welcome Dave posting in this forum.
Does he have any posts?
Yeah. I think my phone was in my pocket and it just automatically went to the Podbender. Like I must have had like I'm just looking. Dan Vakira likes this, blah blah blah.
Alright,
resume Dave Boat.
All right, I think we have enough.
No, there's more. the best Nirvana cover I've ever seen. Okay, I gotta go. I hear Tracy walking by, very upset.
Oh, I bet. Did she listen to Dave Bender?
Sure.
Yeah, there you go. All right, let me do this, and we'll let you go. JohnFreemanMusic.com, JohnFreemanMusic.com, JohnFreemanMusic.com. John Freeman does all the music and all the other crap for the show, and he's a musician. You can hire him, and it'd be really nice if you could. He could write songs for podcasts, and you don't have to fucking pay YouTube or some jackass for stealing their music. It's a nice thing to do. Well, he doesn't do all the music. He didn't do the opening. He's not a young black man. But he could write music for young black men. That's not out of the question either.
That's right, nah.
Beantown Joe Cornyn. Joe Cornyn, the Joe Cornyn Show. Wrestling, opinions, anger, rage. Good friend of the show, Joe Cornyn. Great
the Dave Cornyn Show.
Dave Joe Dan Dave Cornyn Show.
See, I could care less. I just like making jokes. I don't care whose feelings are being hurt as long as I can make a joke about it.
Well, he was so nice to you when your first time on Chopping the Point, wasn't he?
Yeah, well.
Really nice. But I'm sure he was just kidding. Well, I'll tell you right now he wasn't because I heard it offline.
Yeah, what are you going to do? I know I'm better.
Well, you got bad. You wasn't 100% wrong. You're pretty bad, that first one.
Oh, God. I just woke up and, like, hey, you want to be on?
Good point. Yeah, hey, nobody knows what the fuck they're doing, so I just went with it.
I'm sitting and
then,
on my porch.
When I do that, and Dave. He's probably jealous then, too, and then smash you over the head. Right on the show. Yeah, you can listen to one of the minus episodes. See how happy Dave is to hear from Jake.
You should put me on. You should put on that horrible interview we did.
Maybe I will. I should put on Dave. I should put on Dave, like, bashing you afterwards.
Yeah,
just kidding. Ha, ha, ha. Good job.
You should. Because it shows where I was then and where I'm at now.
Yeah. Tommy C stood me up. Ha, ha. You know who he is. Ha, ha, ha. No, just kidding. Well, I don't want to do that because I don't want to play a stupid game that we invented last year for fun because we haven't been on the show and it would be weird. Okay, you don't have to do it. Well, I don't like that stuff anyway.
One of the points is called a dead on tape. Why wouldn't you want to play?
Yeah, you. Your fucking idea. What was it? I don't know. Maybe it was. I'm going to play a stupid fucking game. Yet I don't let you have an opinion about hockey. I don't give you a place to sound off. Did everything I fucking could. I even talked to Jake every week. I was like, God, how can I figure out how to get this guy back on? But I wanted to be a part of every Wednesday release. Didn't work. It's okay. It's not the end of the fucking world. Did I go on and tell everybody what a fucking crybaby you were? I didn't do that. I didn't go on and tell everybody we were problems. I didn't tell you fucking stood me up or got sick. Did I bitch about that? No, I just drove on. Didn't say a bad word about you. In fact, under duress, we said nice things about you. Never again.
You gotta see Martin Brodeur's new mask.
Oh, it sucks, you stupid dogs. You know, I think a lot in this. What's the stupid dog's name? Les, Bez, and Stan.
I don't know. What is he, Bulldogs?
Yeah, and they're called Bez and Stan. Get it? Haha, Bez and the show. Now you know he's a goofball.
Knock it off, okay? That's right.
I think Dave's on his new mask.
Actually, there's one part.
He put
that
Dead
he
on Dave
put
in the back of his mask.
There's one part he did put on to commemorate his dad, going through the 3-0 on the back part of the mask.
Not his dad. I wasn't talking about his dad.
No. There's a new part he just put on. No. It's a film to represent his dad.
Did his dad pass away?
No, his dad's still alive.
Oh, okay. I don't know. How do you commemorate somebody? You only put him on.
Well, just dad. He has all his sons on the back.
Yeah.
I know you're going to say, and his nephews.
His nephews. Yeah, I was thinking about that.
Yeah.
You beat me to the punch.
Yeah, I know. That's why I did it, just to take the sting out of it.
Right. That's it.
And he has a big D on the back for Dave.
For Dave. Dead on Dave Van Kier.
All right, let's get going.
That's it. All right, that's it. Have a good night, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you come back. I hope you see you next summer. This has been a test episode. We dedicate this to the memory of Dead on Dave Camcura, because he's just not going to be on anymore. Goodbye. Fuck off.